So, yeah, we're trying to expand the bedroom, which Russ is coming in, I'll stay in the lot.
I'm in my driveway.
The one thing that's come up with a couple of warehouses is the option for multiple users, and whether they had secured parking, independent parking, truck access for different users. Do you anticipate this to be all your facility and single user, or could you get, you know, if this develops, multiple users that may have to have their own secure parking areas and separate access?
Good question. I had thought about that. I think that potentially I could work for, sublease to somebody else. Now, they need to have separate parking necessarily, probably share the same parking lot.
Well, it wasn't parking per se, it was the secured nature of not wanting other trucks to go through their loading dump areas.
And I think that's for sure something for land development, that would have to be a condition, that if whatever the hours are, your property, you're in charge, so you have a vested interest in making sure, you know, who's coming in and yelling out. But yeah, that's something that we have to talk about.
Just an item that came up with the last two facilities, and now, quite frankly, Triple Net is changing their plan to accommodate a separate secured area or a separate rail.
Zach, one other question. You said 24 hours a day during the week?
Yeah, right now we run Sunday night around 5 p.m., 7 p.m., until Friday night around 5 p.m. That's more open for business. So it's 24 hours a week. We don't run Saturday at all. I plan to close until 5. That's my plan at this point in time.
Okay. So that's the way that 40 years. Cold storage business will work as well?
Yeah, the cold storage, most of that's in the daytime, but the wholesale food business, that runs 24.
Transmission line running through the property, is that confirmed that you're not encroaching on PPL's right of way?
So part of when Zach prepared the property survey, they ran an alternative land title assessment, which included them pulling all the prior property records, which show a 100-foot wide right of way for those. So we're well clear of those. You can see it actually is depicted right here as this dash line. I know it might be tough to see on the screen, but none of the physical above ground improvements are within their right of way. No parking.
You're not looking for any waivers with this plan?
I told the guys, make no waivers, make no variances. Make everything totally perfect. That way nobody can say it's not.
So I'll make one point which Steve made, which is that it's at a sketch level, it's not obviously possible to claim that there are zero waivers. The plan is So the plan as presented is obviously intended to have no waivers, but I think, Steve, the one that you particularly pinpointed, which I believe you are also probably generally aware, is tough to meet maybe in the standards of the ordinance, which is the shade.
The tree shading is the same issue we have.
Correct.
I think when we talk big picture, no waivers, that mean full range improvement, potentially curb winding sidewalks, all the stormwater facilities. Inevitably, you end with technical waivers because of the site.
Yeah. There would be the standard waivers, nothing out of the ordinary, things like material, things like the shade islands that are generally what with most other projects. We wouldn't be seeking any waivers that would be considered unordinary.
Nothing's going to increase intensity or scope of that.
Correct.
It's a sketch. We're here for input and feedback.
Did you look at afforestation for this thing?
So we did, at the time of the sketch, we were only working off of an aerial, and so I know that has to do with our removal of individual trees as well. So the property survey, we had all mature trees surveyed, so we need to take a look at that once we get into the land. But there is significant, again, area. We're only taking up, as far as impervious is concerned, 40% of site. So there's significant area that is already wooded that could be reforested in other regions.
60% is the max impervious, but we have to deb it out.
Correct.
The natural resources and the constraints.
Yeah, so by code for this zoning district, it's 60% is permitted, but once you deduct all of the resources, it ends up to be more like 40%.
50 feet? Yeah. Yeah, after, about the 90.
So you still have...
I can provide the less square footage.
Right.
For sure. That's something I'm going to discuss.
What about, traffic? Would there be a traffic difference between this, this plan and a 50 foot?
Traffic between this plan and a 50 foot? Well, I guess the big question is, if it's 35 feet tall, it doesn't fit where I need. What if I sell it to somebody else? What if they use it for fulfillment? What if it's for a hardware house? I don't know what I'm going to do with it if I sell it. I'd like to have 50. That would work well for me. I'm flexible. I'm open for discussion. I'll reduce the square footage. I can't have 50. I'm willing to do 35. That's probably my business there, unless somebody was to buy it from me instead for something else. I go find 50 feet somewhere else.
Right. But 50 feet's not for us to decide.
Right.
Right.
But in terms of the traffic question, I don't know if I have the answer. It's going to be...
I'm just thinking about
the
nature of the business between the two sides. And
if I have 50 feet, I'll do more cold storage than I will distribution. That'll make less traffic. If I do 50 feet, I don't have to find the customer that turn over more when you do with the motel conversation.
But it's less loading docks. It's less employee parking spaces. And it's less trips in and out of the day subject to a full traffic study that you got to do anyway, right?
Yeah, and less impervious soil. I did a full traffic study already. Right? I need to do another one.
Well, you did the traffic study for zoning. This would have to be updated for the land development plan, depending on which plan you proceed.
The first is a full traffic study.
Well, you'd have to customize it to what the final plan is.
Right.
What do you guys think back here for the neighbors?
How much higher is the 309 at that point than the existing property?
That's a good question. I know that the neighbors 44 feet, the wires are 65 feet. How high was the 309?
We typically agree the 309. I don't have that number off the top of my head, but he didn't. The pharmaceuticals 44, the power line 60, and most of the sure trees in that area are also 50.
Yeah, well.
So you're probably below the height.
Correct.
Yeah. Yeah. All right.
So with this plan, fly right plan with some clean up needed. You have the results of that. I guess the ball's in your court. You have an appeal on the decision.
Well, the ball's in the township's court, the neighbor's court. You can build that or we can build 50 feet small.
We can't build 50 feet yet.
Right. No, it's up to you guys. It's up to the neighbors and the zoning hearing.
Yeah, it's up to the zoning hearing.
But if the answer is no, then I want to do this. I need to do it quickly. Because like he said, my time's running out on my other space I have elsewhere. And my building's full and I have products other places. I need to decide what I'm going to do. And I've already taken the camera for a year. I thought it would take quite as long.
Not a threat, just being up above.
What was that last comment?
It's not a threat saying it's just open box. It's
saying
what the reality is.
Yeah.
Right.
All right, anything else for you guys? All right, so I'll open the floor to public comment. Anyone? State your name and address.
Yeah, Edward Riley. Live at 917 Cat Hill Road.
Okay.
You come up to the mic.
If you want.
I'm really confused about what he's trying to do here. Every time we come to a meeting, he changes his thought. When the first meeting had, he needed 120 feet. He couldn't hire nobody to work there. That's why he needed automated to do that. Now get his 120 feet, now he's down to building this big warehouse. And every time he says something, he's threatening us. Somebody else is gonna come in. You don't give me this, I'm gonna do that. Why would somebody in business buy a property that has one way in on one lane roads to do something like this? I don't understand it. Usually you take something like that and you put it near a highway, the trucks can come in and out. He's telling you he needs to do this. He should have thought of that before he even bought that land or put this process out here. Because every time he's talked, something changes. And I'm telling you, when he gets in here, it's going to be a 120-foot building within no time. I guarantee it, because he's going to do hard shit. I talked to PennDOT at the traffic study, and they were saying they have to do this whole traffic study before he even do that. They're not going to pay any widening or anything. They won't do any of that for that road. So you're talking about all these trucks coming down by my house every day, all Sunday night, all through my neighborhood. There's no room. It's just so small there. You're talking about Houston trucks trying to park down on the road. I worked in the warehouse for 35 years for Kmart. I know when these places get busy, you can't unload that bag because you can't put it all away. So the trucks park out on the road, and that's what they do. So, I mean, every time he says something, every time he changes his philosophy on stuff, and he's saying he's not threatened yet. Well, why would he buy a business that he knows he can't put it? I don't understand it. If you let me know. Because if I was a businessman and I needed a 120-foot building, I sure wouldn't go where they had a variance of 35 feet if I needed to put this building in. He's just trying to buffalo us, isn't it? This is going to turn into a whole nightmare for everybody that lives in there. There's going to be no rest for us. I mean, you're talking trucks coming. You're talking, I can't even get out of my driveway with cars speeding sometimes. You're talking about tractors, trailers. There is a business there. They get maybe two or three trucks a day. That's it. And now he's talking about 150 trucks a day on that little road back and forth, but they can't go out the other way. They have to come up Cat Hill and turn around and right back out the same way. So I'd appreciate if you really think about it.
Yeah, we do.
This is something that really needs to be thought out. I appreciate it.
Thank you. Anyone else? Name and address, please.
Tim Dubois, 603 Cat Hill Road. I mean, I agree with what Ed was saying about the traffic. I don't understand how you all could think that Cat Hill Road could maintain this. I mean, I moved in here 5 years ago, and Cat Hill Road was a complete disaster. Like, not even safe to drive on. And with the Bears trucks driving up and down the road, it's hard to even drive on the road. And if we have all these trucks coming in and out every day, it's just going to be worse. But beyond that, I had a question about the impervious surfaces. We saw a lot of flooding recently, all right? And a lot of people were complaining about there was a new auto put in Percocet, and I assume you're aware of that was put in Fifth Street and Percocet, and a lot of people were saying that that caused, there was flooding on that road where people couldn't drive through. We got a couple inches of rain, and I'm just concerned about, you know, we've had a lot of flooding in the last couple of years. I mean, what are the studies? I don't know what studies they've done. I don't know what they require, but we've seen a lot of flooding in the last years. We had this gigantic new impervious surface that's just going to run into the creek and that bridge where his trucks are going to be coming over. Is that safe? I don't know. That's a question for you guys, I guess.
more the traffic. But anyway.
Well, so who does that go to, PennDOT, or who does that go to?
PennDOT.
Traffic ultimately, PennDOT has to have some interest in it, because of coordination of all the different projects. And Corey Road is a township road, not a state road. Cat Hill Road and State Road are PennDOT roads.
Right, I understand that.
Corey Road in between is a township road. And so the township has interest in potential PennDOT. We, the township has a separate traffic consultant that reviews the reports that they do.
So as far as like pervious surfaces, damaging wetlands and streams and potential bridges down the river?
Yeah, they will have to do a stormwater report similar to the traffic report that addresses the runoff on the property, have probably stormwater management basins or detention basins on the property. That gets reviewed by our office as a township engineer. They also have to submit it to Department of Environmental Protection because they need a special permit from them for stormwater management now. So that has a two level.
Okay, and there's also an environmental study as far as like habitat that's going to be damaged because of that?
Right, there's protection standards in township zoning boards for things like wetlands and whatnot. And as long as they're protecting something away from them, you know, typically it's not.
Well, the property has wetlands, there's wetlands on the property.
Right, and they will provide a wetland report to us. Confirm the extent of those lands.
But who is that going to come from? And if I wanted to ask somebody about that, who would I talk to?
Well, this is a sketch plan submission, so it's really just that piece of paper that's up on the screen. When they make a full preliminary plan submission to the township, they will have to have the traffic study, the stormwater study, wetland study, any other special studies will be included with that information. At that time,
I would have to. Is there going to be a meeting presenting that, or I would have to request
that? Oh, yeah, they'll come back to another meeting just
so
like this.
There would be another meeting. Okay.
And Mr. Gilfillan, you asked about species, habitat, and whatnot. That's something we also have to show as part of our project. We have to, it's called a Kindy report showing if what if there are different species of animals at the site. So and that all gets interviewed.
Yeah, it's just premature to answer a lot of those questions now, but they do have to provide all that information in their preliminary plans.
And that report is run by the state. It's not something they hire to do.
But it would be, you would have a meeting where we would hear all that information and we can understand what all that is.
You
should
see it. Well,
that's what I mean is that I don't have to request, if I come to the meeting, get it presented and I can voice my opinion about those results.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Anyone else?
Monica Riley, 917 Cat Hill Road. I just wanted to say, Zach keeps saying he wants to know what the residents think. I think the residents made it loud and clear at the zoning when you had 100 people come out there and say, we don't want this. I know we don't have a choice. I know it's zoned commercial. You're going to do it. So that's all there is. So why do you want to know what we think? I mean, we already have two people. Hold on. I'd like to finish because I'm probably on the timer. You're not on the timer. You need to keep rambling. So I've listened to you many, many times in every single zone. Okay? So now you made me lose my train of thought. Can you stop the timer a second?
Yeah.
It's just the idea that we've already had two neighbors that are moving. We have one that's already sold their home. We have one that just went up for sale last week because you're ruining our neighborhood. I know you don't really care. I mean, you said you want to know what we think, but you don't care what we think because you're just going to do it, so it's going to be in. It's going to be done. There's nothing we can do but hope on PennDOT. That's pretty much all we got right now. So I just hope PennDOT is the one that squashes you. I mean, because that's the only thing. You can make your smirky faces. We sat there and watched them throughout the whole. You and Malloy, we sat there and watched you in the back, sit and laugh and giggle while people were talking, and it was really disrespectful. And, you know, so you can do whatever you're going to do, going to do it, but I just want you to know that you've ruined our livelihood. We moved here 7 years ago for this neighborhood, and it's destroyed, and it's really sad, you know. We have neighbors leaving, and I'm sure there'll be more, too. So, you can talk, you can get back up and talk, because you've got plenty of time. You'll have to address me directly.
Thanks. Anyone else? Yes, sir.
Phil Phoebus, 635 Cat Hill Road. Monica, I just want to say thank you in this public forum for everything you've done for the neighborhood. It's appreciated.
Thank you.
She's kept us informed. She's done a great job keeping us informed and keeping us in the loop. One of my major concerns with this property is I bought my house 20-plus years ago on Cat Hill Road. Teva, when they started, and yes, it is still Teva in my book also. Teva, I actually was there with one, and that's sad. But Teva, when they first started that proposed warehouse that they were going to put up on this property, and they bought the property, part of that property from the Bates, the 10 acres, they blew out my well. My well is only 120 foot deep. We have to change filters in our on our well every single month due to the damage they cause. I can't get a truck back there to redrill the well because of the location of the well. It's just sad to even think that we're going to go through this all again. So we're going to have a discussion. We'll probably end up with our house up for sale. It is an absolute shame that we're even thinking about this. Yeah.
Anyone else?
Go get
them, buddy. I'm not going to go to the microphone. I need to do that. My name's Anthony Cipriano, 922 Lee Road, Sellersville. I have a couple questions, and maybe it's not appropriate right now. But, how do you intend to handle your sewage and your water? Are you going to handle it through Telford?
Yes.
You are? Okay. Have you talked to Telford about that?
Yes.
Right. Are you aware if you need an environmental impact study to cross that stream?
Yes.
Are you, what's your intention, going over it or under it?
I suppose that there's an existing easement and an existing open pipe below that creek ready for the new construction. So we never do any drilling increase or any pipe there.
Is that a remnant from when Teva crossed it?
That's all it's called. That's all it's
called. When Teva crossed it, they put in a cofferdam in order to do it, and they did put a pipe in it. Are you saying that there is another one that's not being used alongside?
Two more. At least two, maybe two or three more. Yeah.
Okay.
They told me.
Right. All right. So you did check with them? Because I checked with them, too, but they wouldn't give me any information. I'm concerned, like these people, about going down Cat Hill Road. Right now, with nothing basically there except what normally was there, there are trucks that come down there all the time. And when they hit that right in front of Jenny McClure's house, which most of you people know her, their brake retardant system kicks in. And this is at 3 o'clock in the morning, 4 o'clock in the morning, and unbelievable amounts of noise. And that's with the traffic now. When you start running trucks down there, they're going to do the same thing. And then you're going to ask them to make a left to go up Fiery Road. Is that correct?
Yes.
Right. Why does the township always have police officers sitting down there at the garage? There's always a police officer down, well, not always, but frequently. That's because people constantly are going through those stop signs.
Yeah.
Constantly.
Yeah,
and that's a dangerous intersection. And you're going to run gigantic trucks through there. And they're going to make that left. Once they make that left, when they get up to Peaks, they're going to have to make a right to go up Quarry Road. Is that correct?
Up to where?
Quarry Road.
Peak.
And they go through that stop sign all the time. So there's going to be quite a few accidents in that area
And that is a massive problem, as I see it. And then they're going to have to get out when they get to the end of Quarry Road. Is there a traffic light going to be installed there? That's the question for the state.
Your time is up.
I used all mine, so he's got mine.
That's all right. I got my point across.
Yes, yes. Thank you.
We gave Ed a lot.
Anyone else? All right. Seeing no more public comment, we're going to move forward.
We have a decision to make.
You have a decision.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
I do now. No, no worries.
Tollgate Road, so that actually coming out.
Right, you're trying to cut across.